I'm Allie Buckman, and I am going to show you one of Anna's designs today, and this is the boxcar bracelet. We thought it looked kind of like coal cars or boxcars of a train. The beauty of this bracelet is that it's really, really flexible. If you want to tighten up the sides and you don't want that flexibility, I'll kind of explain how to do that, but I like how bendy it is and how flexible and how those beads really kind of stick up and have that bracelet be three-dimensional. I'm going to be using a number of different styles of beads that I'm working with, a bunch of different two-hold and also the quadratile. So to start out explaining, we're going to be doing the quadratile here on this side, and I'm going to be using the coral pink in that color or in that type. And the quadratile is a 6mm four-hold tile bead. So that's going to be on the sides casing in my round duo beads. For my round duo beads, I'm using the zinc iris in the round duo color. And then I'm also going to be using some two-hold triangles. Instead of using two-hold bars, which Anna used here, I'm going to show you what it would look like with two-hold triangles, just to change it up a little bit. I do have two different colors of 11 OC beads that I'm working with. I'm working with the dark topaz rainbow gold luster, which brings in kind of that pink and green tones and that muted tone that I'm going for. And then I have the galvanized green steel in the 11O as well. To close it all off, I have a cup button, and I'm going to be using the magic wine. We just got in the magic colors of the cup buttons, and this really kind of pulls that all together with that beautiful wine color, adding all of these beads together. Handy, I have a size 10 English beading needle, and I'm going to be using one needle, and I have my thread zap on my bead tray here. I'm working on a bead mat. I have my slip and snip scissors handy. I have my super new glue handy. I am working with 0.006 wildfire beading thread. And to flatten that out, I usually have a pair of pliers kind of sitting next to me. Once you cut or burn that thread, it's nice to flatten it out before going into your needle. We are going to start off with about 5 feet of beading thread. And we're going to be working first with the base and the bottom of the bracelet. So when you're looking here, we're going to be working with everything basically but our round duo beads. So you're going to want to make little piles of all of your beads to start out with and about 5 feet of your thread. So I've got my thread on my needle and I'm going to get ready to get started. I'm going to start actually at my loop end and work from my loop end down towards my button end. Again, what we're really doing is we're working with the base right now. So I'm not working with my round duos at all. I have those kind of pushed off to the side. What I'm going to be doing first is making my loop, and then kind of continuing on with my project, creating that baseline. I am going to start by adding a stop bead, and the stop bead is usually a bead that's a different color. So I have a silver bead sitting here in an 11O, and I'm going to put that on the end of my thread. I'm going to leave myself just about 2 inches or so at the end of my thread, running the needle through that bead 2 times. That bead then eventually is going to come off my project. That's why I'm using one that's a different color. Also, it's good to use one that's a different color because then you know it's not actually part of your project and by accident string through it. So I'm going to do my loop first, and I'm going to do my loop actually in my galvanized green steel color, and I'm going to add 26 beads onto my needle. Once I have those 26 beads on, I'm going to let them drop down next to that stop bead. If you're using a clasp, a toggle or a lobster clasp, you would be actually putting that on right now. If you are using a metal clasp, I always recommend using a wire protector when you're working with thread. That way you won't see the thread and you'll have the wire protector on. So I'm gonna let all of those beads drop down next to that 11O seed bead. That's my stopper. Once I have those on, I'm going to take my needle and thread, reinforcing my loop and going back through all of those beads from my bead stop, not through it, because remember it's coming off. So I'm going back through that whole line of beads, getting my needle through all of them. Once I have those through the whole way, I'm going to give a nice little pull. And that's going to tighten it up so I have my loop there. You want to make sure that your loop is going to fit whatever closure you're doing. So if you happen to be doing something else, you may want to measure that because 26 beads may not work for you. And here at the end, Anna did not use one of the two-hold bars she did on this side, but I'm going to start actually with one of my two-hold beads. So I'm going to be starting with my two-hole triangle. Before that, I'm going to start with a little bit of this ladder stitch. So I'm going to add two of my galvanized steel beads. And I'm going to take my needle and thread through the first bead on the other side of the stopper and the bead that I'm coming out of in a circular fashion. And what that's going to do is force those beads to sit right on top, side by side there. I want to take my thread and needle then back through those beads. So this is a ladder stitch that we're doing here. So we came through those two beads. Let me get this tail out of the way for you so it doesn't confuse you. And once I have it through those two beads there, I'm going back through and circling it around and giving a tight pull. And that's going to place my two beads then right on top of the other ones there. And that's how I'm going to connect my two-hole triangle. My two-hole triangle, I'm going to be starting with that two-hole triangle and then coming through basically in that same design and adding two beads on the other side and circling back around. So I'm going to add my triangle through one of the holes. It doesn't matter for this one which one you do. It's going to matter after this though, so that way we get all of our triangles facing in the same direction. As I'm on the bottom then, below my beads here, you're going to have to think about what color you want to use. So you can use the same color below and the same color on the sides of your round duo. That's up to you. I'm going to be using my transparent rainbow color. So I'm going to pick up two of those. So back through the two-hole triangle in the opposite direction. That's going to put my two 11 OC beads on the side. Once those two are on the side of my triangle, I'm going to take my needle and thread and go back through the two seed beads that we added. So I'm circling back around. And that creates that connection there. I'm going to go back through my two-hole triangle and back through the 11 O's coming out this side of them. Once I have that then, what I'm going to be doing, and you can see that point kind of sitting up there, is I'm going to be connecting the sides here. So I'm going to be connecting my quadratiles. And when I connect those tiles, I'm going to also be creating that loop and coming around as well. So to do that, I'm going to go through one of my tiles. Doesn't matter which hole. When I'm on the side of my tile here, I'm going to be making my X's in the galvanized green steel color. But the center bead of my X's, I'm actually going to make in my rainbow color. So I'm going to do one green, one rainbow, one green. And then I'm going to go through the hole beside, making sure you're not going on an angle. So you want to make sure that you're going one of the holes beside the quadratile. If you go on an angle, it's going to angle. If you go on the angle, it's going to end up angled. So you want to make sure to go beside the bead there. You're going to pull the thread through and force those beads to sit on the side of the quadratile. You also want to make sure that you have a lot of tension between the different beads because you don't want to have a lot of thread showing. Once you have this start here, you are going to come back and we're going to add our next three beads and cross over to our next quadratile. So I'm going to add my two rainbow beads, then I'm going to add a tile, my pattern, which is my green, rainbow, green, force that all down next to my project. And then if you're not sure where you're going, you can actually just kind of hold it on the side here. And I'm going to be bringing the thread and needle back through the tile. And at the same time, I want to go back through the 11 O's on the other side and the tile on the other side. If you can, at that same point, you can go ahead and go through that first steel bead on the tile. Pull all that thread through, and that's going to get your first little boxcar started. So at this point, I am actually going to grab some of my round duos. I'm going to revamp the instructions a little bit and show you guys how to add them now at this point. It's going to create less thread passes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through coming out that galvanized steel, that green steel, and I'm also going to go through my rainbow color bead. So my thread and needle are going to be coming out on the side there. What I'm going to do then is create that X effect, and to go from the top to the bottom, I'm going to be adding two beads. I'm going to add those in that green steel color and sew through the top hole of my quadratile. This is going to be the top hole the furthest away from my loop. Pulling the thread through then, I get the start of that X. Once I'm through the top here, I'm going to add one of my rainbow through one hole of my round duo, add another rainbow bead, and through to the other quadratile, also the top hole. Pulling my thread through then, that'll get my round duo bead to sit right in place there. I do need to lock it down on the other side, and to do that, I'm going to add two of my steel beads, sew through that middle off-color bead on the side of the quadratile from the base row, that's going to pull that up there. Then add two more of the steel color. Sew through the quadratile there, coming out then towards the round duo bead. That's going to finish off my X on the side. I'm going to pick up one of my rainbow beads, sew through that zinc round duo, pick up another rainbow, sew through my quadratile. So it's almost making like a little beaded bead. Once I'm there and I'm on the side here, I'm going to add my two more of my steel. Sew through the 11-0 that is here, that rainbow one. And I'm also at the same time going to sew through the galvanized steel from the bottom row there. When you're pulling that through then, that creates your second X and creates your little box car. So that's what makes it kind of fan out, is that effect. It's also because the top is going to be wider than the bottom. Once I'm through the bottom then, I'm going to go through my quadratile, through the base hole next to that steel color, through those two topaz rainbow beads and come out. We're going to get ready to start that whole thing over again. So when I'm coming out here on the side, I'm going to start by adding my two-hole tile, or my two-hole triangle. When I go through this time, I want to make sure that the peak is going to sit up. You don't want them sitting up and down, up and down. We always want our peaks to be sitting up. So I'm going to go through the hole, making sure that that peak and that empty peak is at the top. Once I have that there, I'm going to come out of it just like I did the other side by adding two of my topaz beads back through the other side towards the project. Once I have it through there, I'm going to grab the two beads that I'm coming out of there on the base. You can see a little bit better those two beads. I'm going to go back through them again and come out. That's going to loop that all together and make that sit up. Going back through that two-hole triangle, back through the two topaz beads. So you're circling the whole way around that, almost in that ladder stitch formation, creating a join between those beads. When I flip it over then, you can see the peaks and you can see your first little boxcar has been created. And we're going to continue then adding on to the boxcars. So again, to get the next portion here, we're going to be adding our quadratile. Doesn't matter which hole right now. I'm going to be adding our three beads in. Our steel, topaz steel. I'm going to go back through the quadratile, making sure now as I come back through it that I'm going through the bead that's the hole that's beside it, not across. I'm going to add two more of my topaz beads and pick up another quadratile. Let that all drop down next to my project. Add my three beads like I did on this previous side, making sure that your quadratile is facing the same direction so the empty holes are going to be at the same place on each one. Going back through that second hole, the one next to it, back through those two topaz beads, out the quadratile, and out that galvanized green steel. Give a nice tight pull, and that's creating that second box. It's easiest, and you can see, it's easiest to show you just when we're working with it, how I'm doing it by the bottom side, because the top side has those peaks in the round duo. So it's easier to see what's going on. That's why I'm holding it on the bottom. When I get to the top here, I'm gonna add in my round duo bead. So I'm going through that topaz rainbow bead. And then gonna add two more steel coming out the top of my quadratile. Once I'm out the top, then I'm going to add one of my topaz, round duo topaz, go through to the other side of my two hole of my quadratile. You can see which hole I'm coming out of, the one right above there. Two more steel go on, grabbing that topaz bead there. That's going to start that X formation. Two more go on, back through that quadratile towards the center. Give a tight pull, add another topaz, and force that round duo to sit in place. If you see that you have a lot of gap going on, you want to go in and kind of pull those threads. So make sure that it's nice and tight there and pull and get rid of all that slack that's there. After I put on my 11-0 seed bean, I'm gonna pull my round duo in place, add another one on my topaz beads, come out the last open hole of my quadratile, give a tight pull, add two more of my steel beads in place, and then I'm going through my topaz bead, through my galvanized steel, through my quadratile, and through those two topaz beads. And then pull your needle out after the two topaz before the second quadratile. And that gets your second little box car. What you're gonna do now is just continue the entire bracelet, adding these box cars into place and kind of dropping that round duo almost like it was your coal in. So you're just going to continue this same pattern the whole length of your bracelet. When you're working with it here, Anna has 17 round duos, and that leaves you with 34 of your quadratiles that you'll need, and 17 of the, or 18 of the two-hole triangles, I'm sorry. That's gonna give you about a 6¾-inch bracelet. If you know you needed to make it a little bit longer, you may wanna pick up 18 or 19 of your round duos as you're working. So I've just run out of thread. I'm almost done here. I have a couple more little box cars to make, probably about two more. I'm gonna show you how to add thread onto this project. I'm in between one of my box cars, so I'm about to add one of my triangles, and I've just taken my needle off the thread. What I'm going to do now is add a new piece of thread. So I've taken about 24 inches of thread because I'm almost done, so I don't need a ton, and I've threaded my needle onto that new piece of thread. I'm going to go to the end of that thread, the end opposite the needle, leaving about 3 inches. I'm going to take this new thread and tie it around the older piece of thread. So I'm not going to be using the older piece right now. I'm just tying it in a loop right around. What this is going to do is make that knot, as I tie it here, able to move up and down the existing thread. I'm giving a nice tight pull, but that knot is going to be able to move up and down that little tail thread. What I want to do is give a nice tight pull again, and then I'm going to slide that knot as close as possible down to my 11 OC beads that my thread is coming out of. I'm going to take those two threads now and tie them in a knot together. So this time I am incorporating both threads. Give a nice tight pull, and then I'm going to switch the hands that my thread is holding. So I was going right over left over right. I'm going to do the opposite now since I switched hands. I have those two pieces of ends on now. And because this is a non-traditional bead weaving project, I'm not going to weave them back in. I'm going to let them hang out. As I get to the end of my project, I'll take my super new glue, and I will glue that knot there. The thread that I'm working with then is going to continue building the rest of my boxcars. So I'm going to go in now, add my next triangle, and just continue on, just as if I never ran out of thread to begin with. If you want to, you can cut those tails down a little bit, but it is a good idea to keep them there just so you remember where you did add the thread. Because sometimes you can add the thread so well that you can't actually even see where the knot goes right next to, because it's right there in between that bead on the side. Once you have your next set added, then you're just going to continue doing your boxcars. And as I add them, I'm going to get ready after I have them completed. I'm going to get ready in order to add my cup button here in that beautiful magic wine color. So I'm at the end of my boxcar bracelet here, and you can see how slinky it is and how nice it is to do. Like I said, if you did want it to be firmer and stiffer and not have that little bit of stretch to it, you could go down the sides here after we're done adding our cup button and actually link into all of the off-colored bead as you go along the sides. I'm, though, just going to add the clasp and keep it to that slinky. I like when you put it on for it to have that kind of slinky design to it. So once we're at the end here, what I've done is continued doing the box card just like I was going to get ready to do my next car. However, instead of adding my topaz luster beads here, what I've done is added that galvanized green steel instead, just to repeat the start and to get that look from the start. What I'm going to do now is attach my cup button. So you want the cup button to sit off just a tiny little bit because you don't want it to lay right over top of the project. What you want to do to figure out exactly how long to add your clasp if you're doing a button or a clasp closure. If you're doing a clasp closure, you could add your wire protector right after this and use that loop that's connected there to add your closure. For my cup button, I want it to sit off just enough that my button has room to play around. So what I'm going to do is I am going to actually pick up 4 of my galvanized steel color. I'm then going to go up through the back of my cup button and come out on the dome side. Once I'm in the middle there, I'm going to add 3 of my 11 OC beads, also in that steel color. If I add the other color, you're not really going to see it very much. And I'm going to come down the other side of the cup button. If you wanted to, you could also add one of your tiles there in the middle, that quadratile, and just do it on an angle. Then I'm going to add 4 more beads. And I'm going to go back in to that last, or those first 11 O's, that we're coming off of my two-hole triangle. What that's gonna do is circle that around completely, and you're gonna pull that in. And that creates that loop. That gives you a comfortable distance that cup button can go completely back, and it's not gonna interfere with the bracelet. You can see the 3 beads are just gonna decorate the top of the cup button there, and I'm going to reinforce this clasp by going back through everything that I just added. whenever you have a clasp or a closure, you always want to make sure to sew back through it multiple times, because that's where the wear and tear on the bracelet is going to be. Once you're back through two or three times, I'm going to show you how we're going to just tie off and finish our project. Coming back through those last two beads again. And then pulling that tight. It creates almost a little rectangle effect. What I'm going to do then is go through that loop that I've created with my needle. I'm right on the corner there. I'm making a loop with the thread. And then I'm going to take my needle and sew back through that loop. And just do a little sewer's knot. That's going to create a knot right there on the end. I'm going to go up right below the button, come out as well, and do the same thing. Go in through the loop, creating a knot, or creating a loop, and then bringing my thread through that loop, making sure not to connect or to go onto any of my beads there. I'm going to go back up through. The same time when you're going up the cup button, it's always a good idea, if you can, to catch that first C bead that's in the middle, because that makes it hard, if you don't, to come down the other side. So this is my third time through. I'm going through those two C beads, coming down the other side then, and coming out. Once I'm out the end of the cup button here, I'm going to tie my last little loop, going through my C bead loop there, making a loop and sewing through it. Pulling that tight then. And that's going to be the end of my bracelet. What I'm going to do now is take my super glue, and I am going to glue right here as well as where I added thread. I'm going to come back to the other side here, take my stop bead off, and put a needle onto this end here. So I've gotten my needle back on my original end here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to sew through the bead next to where the thread is coming out of, towards me, and I'm showing the underside of my bracelet, and I'm going to come out of that bead. I'm going to reinforce this connection point here by sewing back through two times. Once I have it sewn back through there two times, creating that connection, I'm going to go back in and create my little half loops there and create my knots. So same thing the sewer's knots here creating. I'm going to create about three sewer's knots, just like I did on the other side, right there around the clasp. And then I am going to super glue and finish off this end as well. You can see my thread on this side is short, so I'm actually taking the needle through backwards. That's a little hint. Also, if you have a wide eye needle, it's a good point to put that on there. And once you have that thread there and knotted a couple times, what you're going to do is, again, just give it a little bit of glue and then either burn or trim your ends down. Once you've gotten that all taken care of, your boxcar bracelet is going to be finished. It has a great silky feel to it, and I like how flexible it is and how easy it is to put on and off because of its stretch, and yet it holds. So it's a great fun design using the quadra tiles, which are a little bit difficult and kind of fun and funky, and then the pyramids in place of Anna's two hold bars, so you could use either. It just gives you a little bit of a different look. You could also use a super duo or a mini duo, anything that has two holes there, but the triangles here have a fun look to them because of the rounded versus the spike. So it's a fun bracelet to use up some of your new shapes that you've gotten. If you haven't gotten a chance to get the new shapes, you can visit us at PotomacBeads.com. Check out the locations page and visit a store near you. If you can't get to a store near you, you can always shop with us online for the great products like these. There are links to these products below in the details underneath this if you do show more. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can get updates when we do new videos, new designs, as well as new product updates. Thanks a lot for watching, everyone, and happy beading. Have fun making this boxcar bracelet.
Thank you.